Do you by chance remember this movie? This movie is called Zathura, and it's a movie that I haven't watched in over 10 years. I only remember bits and pieces of this movie. It's really weird, and I remember it being really scary when I was a kid. We had this on DVD, and I watched it when I was 7 years old. That was like 2010. So I'm actually really excited to watch this movie and give my honest thoughts on it. So let's just jump right into the movie.
Yes, here it is. Zathura, a space adventure.
So the movie starts out with these two kids playing catch with their dad. One of them's real good at it, and one of them sucks. The older brother decides to be a dick and intercept. The dad makes it clear that him and his wife are divorced and that she got the house, so he is in this old creakety house.
It's not creepy, it's old.
I like mom's better.
Well, so did she, and now it's hers.
Damn. He wants to work, and the kids keep wanting his attention, so he snaps a little bit.
There's only one of me, okay?
Damn.
So climb off my back and give me about 2 inches of space, will you please?
And then he's like, bro, it's whatever. Walter and Danny get in a fight, and Danny throws a football and knocks over his cranberry juice all over his beautiful drawing. Now he's gotta go to the store and print out a new one. So he wakes up Lisa, Christian Stewart, who falls right back asleep. Danny wants to watch SpongeBob, but Walter wants to watch Sports Ball, and they have this whole feud about it. He just doesn't want to do anything with his little brother. Danny throws his ball at Walter's face on accident, and Walter starts chasing him throughout the house. So Danny hides in his little box compartment thing. So Walter lowers Danny all the way into the basement. To be fair though, this is a scary ass basement. A real kid though would not get out, they would stay in there and they would panic and cry. Danny walks around this creepy big ass dungeon with a furnace in it. Why would he do that? Danny stumbles around a bit until he finds this game board called Zathura. A super sweet ass looking board game. Danny manages to get out of the basement somehow.
You're really mean.
And he tries to show Walter his new board game, but Walter says that it's for babies.
Yeah, you would, it's for babies.
Danny eyes the Zathura board and starts clicking with it. Eventually he hits blast off and something starts happening.
A card came out. Fascinating.
He gets a card that says meteor shoe.
Shoe.
Oh wait, no, that says meteor shower.
I have no idea. All it says is take you face fa-
The Bose TV turns off and everything starts shaking. At this point they should probably start moving. Christian Stewart literally doesn't even care that there's a meteor shower. Danny grabs the hamster and runs into the furnace. And then Sports Ball comes back on. It's smashed by a giant meteor. Okay.
I don't think we should play that game anymore.
Laugh track. Add the laugh track. Zathura establishes that it is a very, very threatening game. Danny opens the door and sees something he never thought he would have seen in his whole life.
Walter, check this out.
Just kidding, they didn't see the funny cat. I just spent like 2.5 hours masking that. I don't know why I did that. I'll include the green screen at the very end of the video. But this is what they actually saw. Danny and Walter realize that they are in space, and for some reason, Walter goes right up to the edge. Why would you ever do such a thing? Danny and Walter kind of realize the situation they're in and go back inside the house. This movie looks pretty good for 2005. Christian Stewart doesn't even know that she's in space. Danny and Walter kind of freak out about who should tell Christian Stewart. We in space.
It's already dark, I'm gonna be so late.
It's not in outer space.
And for some reason they start playing the game in her room. Lisa is an incredibly irresponsible person.
Is the house on fire?
No.
Is anyone hurt?
No, but
then leave.
For some reason they're really excited even though they know the last one pretty much almost killed them.
The card!
Lisa doesn't care.
Shipmate enters cryonic sleep chamber for 5 turns.
Then they
Does cryonic mean ice?
For the next 5 turns, they accidentally freeze their sister. Once they manage to open the door, this is what she looks like. Like, they killed her. She's dead. Her ass is literally dead.
I killed her!
Yeah, she's dead. This must have been excruciating. For some reason, Walter thinks that she's not dead, and Walter does some crazy psycho shit.
Are you crazy? Maybe we should read the instructions.
The instructions say that the game isn't going to end until it ends.
That's it. We gotta keep playing.
Danny's kind of spitting some facts and saying that only bad shit happens when they play, but Walter wants to win and get them home. Walter gets a card that says,
"Your robot is defective."
We don't even have a robot.
They see this huge shadow, only for it to be this little guy.
That's your robot?
Yes, I got one.
Give me a juice box, biatch.
Oh my god. The robot starts to get bigger, and then the kids realize that they might be in trouble.
Alien life form must destroy.
Fire shoots out of its back and legs, and it launches at the kids. You gotta be kidding me, man. After the dust settles, they think it's over, but then it starts moving again. Walter tells Danny to take his turn, ASAP.
Danny, take your turn.
But the key is missing from the board.
There's no key!
Walter sees the key, but freezes for a minute. The robot breaks free, but he still manages to get the key and bring it to the board. The robot pulls out a spinning blade saw and starts sawing itself out of the wall. The robot escapes and starts chasing Walter around the house. Something I actually really like about this scene is that Walter is taking the same path that Danny took when Walter was chasing Danny earlier in the movie. Except this time, the robot flies out of the fucking window.
Why didn't you go? I could have been killed!
I was scared, but it's okay, he's gone, isn't he?
The robot comes buzzing through the other window. Just so much disrespect for the property, man. And for some reason, Danny still hasn't taken his turn. The robot starts gearing up and Danny takes his turn. For some reason, Walter and the robot kind of have like a Western standoff.
The card!
Danny gets his card and they jump. Then Walter ran away without ever reading what the card said. Apparently, the card was that they're 2 inches away from the fucking sun. The house starts turning, so everything starts falling on its side. The hamster dies. Christian Stewart shatters.
You passed too close to Source 3! Hit her gravity field!
And the robot is still after Walter. The robot is closing in, and gravity starts pulling on the house. At this point, Danny is just barely hanging on, and Walter is under a spinning blade. Danny gets closer to falling as the lamp he's holding on to breaks. The lamp finally gives, and Danny flies into the window, but doesn't break it. The robot grabs Walter's shoe and pulls him down, but he falls through the wall. Both Walter and Danny fall at the same time, and them falling is interspliced with one another. So here's them falling just by themselves. The hamster is alive, and Christian Stewart is definitely dead. Lisa's frozen corpse bumps into Walter, which kind of freaks him out a little bit. They go to investigate the robot and find that it's mostly broken. For now, it's been disabled. But Walter wants to look closer. He only wants a closer look, though, so that he can get his shoe back. Just give me my damn Jordan back. Walter gets his shoe, but I'm pretty sure the robot is repairing itself now. And they carry Lisa up the stairs. They go and put her back where she came from.
Looks about right.
Walter continues to take his next turn. And he's kind of snarky about it, too. Walter gets a good card, but Danny refuses to play.
Okay, your turn.
I'm not playing!
He just wants to make mac and cheese.
What are you doing?
Making mac and cheese.
Walter tries to convince Danny to go, but he does not want to go.
Can we at least talk about this?
There's nothing to talk about. I'm not going.
Danny has a list of reasonable demands to be treated like a normal brother.
I want you not to be mean to me, not ignore me. I want you to treat me like your brother.
And Walter complies.
Fine.
So Danny takes his next turn.
You are visited by Zorgons.
Which might be the worst card in the whole game.
Just visitors.
And they trash their whole kitchen and they're super loud. When the Zorgons finally stop, they arrive at the front door.
Maybe they're friendly.
Oh, a quirky one-liner.
They're not friendly!
They again hide in the fireplace, which nearly results in their death. The Zorgons keep on firing, and Christian Stewart almost dies again. Walter takes his next turn, because what are you supposed to do? Because why not? The card says reprogram, and he shoves it in the window like it will do something.
Reprogram!
Which nearly blows him up. Danny doesn't want to play anymore, but Walter tells him to keep going, as it usually goes.
Go!
Go!
No!
Go!
Danny's card says,
"Rest on standing astroturf."
What?
Rescue stranded astronaut! I guess there's gonna be some stranded astronaut or something!
That scene looks really funny. Danny's card says, "Rescue stranded astronaut," and then this guy shows up. He rung the doorbell upside down. This is their first real ally in the film. He literally just shows up and starts spitting facts.
Don't be so quick to sell out your brother, kid. He's all you got.
He says they have a pretty bad Zorgon problem, and his advice is to hide. But not to hide themselves. To hide.
Hide. We're gonna hide the house.
The astronaut says to turn off all the lights. Also, the flame on the stove has been going that whole time. Walter has to go back into the basement, but can't because the robot's still in there. So instead of going down there himself, he just goes and does it through some clicker in the hallway. After Danny turns off all the lights, the Zorgon stop moving. The astronaut lights his couch on fire.
You wanna help me get this out of here?
And chucks it out the door. And for some reason it keeps burning. I'm pretty in space, wouldn't it like go out or something? Doesn't fire need oxygen to burn? The astronaut is talking like he's Chris Pratt holding off the Velociraptors.
Take it. Follow it.
For some reason the Zorgons follow the burning couch. The astronaut shares some information about the Zorgons, like they're heat seekers and that they eat meat.
Big gnarly lizards, cold-blooded heat seekers. A spark of warmth will bring them in like moths. Real problem is their ravenous appetite.
What do they eat?
Meat.
That's good.
Dude, your meat.
The astronaut just starts eating all their food and making himself a sandwich.
I'm doing this because I've been eating paste out of a tube for 15 years.
I'm gonna say something.
Walter.
Why'd he say it like that?
I don't think a couple Dagwood sandwiches is too much to ask for.
Dog, you're eating it all.
This dialogue. Walter wants the astronaut to leave because he's eating all their food.
Oh, you telling me to leave?
But the astronaut says that Danny spun him, so he has to decide if he leaves or not.
That's not your call. You spun me.
But then, Walter busts out his Fleet Admiral card, like a true Sigma male, and the astronaut backs down.
I apologize.
That's when we find out that the astronaut is also a fleet admiral, and that it's just a card.
It's just a card, Bugnuts!
So has he been here for a long time, or no? Did he play this game when he's a kid and he's been here until the point that he's an adult? Are they both the same person? Was he trapped here by this board? Walter was winning, but he realizes that his piece is in second place, and he accuses Danny of cheating. They immediately start fighting again, but the astronaut breaks it up. This time, they get a yellow card. Walter must have moved the piece too far because he got caught for cheating and now he's getting sucked into space.
You grab it and I'll pull you down! I can't hang on any longer!
Walter gets permanently sucked into space, but the astronaut goes to go get him. They're gone for a little bit, but end up coming back safely. Walter is pissed off and just wants to get out of here.
Get away from me. Can you just play so I can get the heck out of here and get away from you? Lose map of galaxy. Go back two spaces.
But now that it's been 5 turns, Christian Stewart wakes up. Lisa turns the furnace back on, which starts heating the house back up.
Yes! 9. Good roll. Good roll. 9's a great roll.
Walter gets a great roll and gets a gold card.
Gold?
Super lucky. Too bad he gets in a fight with Danny right away and yells some pretty heinous things.
It's your fault Mom and Dad got divorced!
Hey!
You suck!
It's kind of implied that he's going to wish away his little brother. Wish that he didn't exist or was never born.
Get my wish now, don't I?
Don't wish what you're thinking.
You don't know what I'm thinking. Dude, won't come
tell
to
me what you wished for.
Get off me.
And the astronaut goes into a panic frenzy. He goes up the stairs to look for Danny and doesn't see him there.
Card worked.
Yeah. It worked. Congratulations. We're stuck in space now forever.
Leave him alone.
After that, Danny pops his head out from under the bed, and Walter says that he wished for a football.
This?
The astronaut sits down with Danny and Walter, and we find out more about his past. He says that him and his brother played the game 15 years ago, and that they would fight a lot, but the board game Zathura made them fight even more. Apparently, he had gotten the gold card too, and when he had got the gold card...
I wish that my brother had never been born.
Oh my god.
We find out that he's extremely remorseful about this decision and that he's never been able to finish the game because he wished away his other player. They all band together to finish this game for good this time, when they realize that it's been getting hot.
Is it getting hot in here?
Christian Stewart turned the furnace back on, which brought the Zorgons back, where they find a huge chunk of the living room has been blown off. Oh yeah, and the gerbil's finally dead this time for real.
Oh
terrible was in there.
Very bad.
The astronauts and the kids start breaking the furniture and putting it into the furnace. They have a lot of furnaces in this house. Kristen Stewart just finished her shower, and she's getting ready in the bathroom when she starts to smell something.
Walter?
She comes downstairs only to see that they've started a huge fire in the kitchen.
You guys actually set the house on fire!
Lisa finally acts like a responsible adult at the worst time possible.
No, Lisa,
Lisa rightfully asks who this guy is.
Who the hell are you?
Where he has some quirky dialogue.
The astronaut. Danny spun me.
Lisa's rightfully freaking out.
What is that? What is that? What's going on? Where are we?
But they do kind of ignore her.
Somebody please talk to me right now!
What's a Zorgon?
They're lizard men. They eat meat. We're meat!
The Zorgons start boarding the house. Lisa goes downstairs to find the robot. She sees the astronaut and there's this really weird scene where she's like looking at his eyes. And she says like the weirdest line of dialogue. The Zorgons keep on shooting harpoons in the house as they go upstairs. The Zorgons end up connecting their ships to the house so that they can board. The astronaut gives the boys the walkie-talkie and tells them to hide in the closet. He says that he's going to sneak on board the ship and steal the game back. For some reason, Lisa is just like the thirstiest person ever.
He has gorgeous eyes. What? He obviously feels very protective over me. I just feel so safe around him.
She needs to calm her ass down, bruh. Over the walkie-talkie, he says he's gonna go get the game.
Zorgons, Lisa's crawling with them. They're all over the basement. I think in the corner I see the game. The box is right there. I'm gonna get closer.
I remember watching this part as a kid. It was incredibly tense. The astronaut cuts off the walkie-talkie for a bit as Zorgons walk around outside. The doorknob starts to spin. When the astronaut walks back in, the astronaut says that he couldn't get the game, that it was right by the furnace. Danny has an idea that he can get into the dumbwaiter to go down to the furnace. The astronaut is too big, but Danny is not.
Sure wish we knew someone that was small enough.
Okay, bruh. Danny gets in the dumbwaiter as they send their little brother to their death.
Listen to me. This could be real easy, okay? Because I'm your brother. And that's what being a brother means.
Okay, bruh.
I never let anything happen to you.
Danny apologizes for cheating, and it's very sweet.
I'm sorry I cheated. I know.
As they lower Danny into the dumbwaiter, they see a Vorgon through the stairs. Danny gets impatient and starts hopping around in the dumbwaiter and the wheel breaks. The astronaut burns his hands trying to stop him from falling. The Zorgon comes back after hearing this.
They're coming up the stairs.
Everyone else goes to hide while the astronaut stays behind to hold the rope for Danny. Danny sees the board game and inspects the basement. He picks up the box, but it's just the lid. A Zorgon upstairs creeps down the hallway and sees a rope tied to the stairs. Danny sees the game board inside the ship.
Wait, I see the game.
They tell Danny not to go, but he sneaks onto the ship anyways. He decides to stop being a baby because he sneaks right by three big-ass Zorgons. Danny jumps on the ship and goes towards the board. He reaches for the board but hides behind the junk after he sees a Zorgon. He tries to grab it and ends up throwing it onto the incinerator belt. Danny leaves behind his walkie-talkie and a Zorgon smashes it. Danny ran away and is trying to get to the board. He steps on Zorgon poop. He has to sneak past these alien goat with some bug-ass eyes, but he's still determined to go get this game board. As the Zorgon is about to throw Zathura in the incinerator, he sees that the goats have been let loose. He throws the game board on the floor and walks away. Danny, with the game board in hand, runs back to the basement, but he still has to sneak past the Zorgons to get to the dumbwaiter. He puts the game board in the dumbwaiter and then crawls in, with the alien poop all over his shoes. He pulls on the rope before they're ready to pull him up, so a Zorgon slashes the rope. Another Zorgon notices the foot trail that he left behind, notices Danny, and alerts all the other Zorgons to go chase him. Danny runs to the basement and escapes.
Told you I wouldn't let anything happen to you.
But there are Zorgons upstairs too. That's when the robot breaks through.
Emergency.
He grabs Walter by the neck, and Walter shows him the reprogram card.
Reprogram!
That's when the robot switches gears and starts protecting the boys instead. The robot propels himself towards the aliens, and the Zorgons start running away immediately to get away from him.
Flying.
Zorgons trip over themselves and everything explodes as they try escaping from the robot. But there's one Zorgon left over. He gets hit with a piano. Danny goes and he spins a 9, but he has to go back one extra space.
Go back one space.
It's Walter's turn to spin and he gets a 3. He went back 3 spaces, forward 3 spaces, and he got another gold card so he can make another wish. This is how Walter uses his other wish. What?
You wished for 2 of me? No, I wish the astronaut guy had his brother back.
This is where we find out that this was just an older version of Walter this whole time. Danny and green screen Danny kind of look at each other funny for a second, and then he fades away and gets reabsorbed into other Danny. Walter just wished for another Danny back, and Danny ate the other Danny.
That was awesome.
I'm assuming little Walter absorbs big Walter. What if he absorbed little Walter? That's priceless. What if big Walter absorbed little Walter, and then it was just adult Walter left?
He was me.
Oh my god, and I wanted to...
Yeah, it also means that Lisa was attracted to her brother the whole time. The Zorgons bring back all their friends and start blowing up the house again. Really, just explosions everywhere. It's nonstop. Danny moves ahead one space.
One. God, I suck.
But his card tells him to move ahead 9 spaces.
Star, move ahead 9 spaces. Danny, you won.
I won?
You won? You won, Danny. Beat the game! Oh!
Too bad someone left the gas on and the explosion killed them all. Just kidding, this roll was enough to beat the game, and then the Zathura ball just starts floating and spinning and it opens up. Sparks fly everywhere as the game erupts. And it teleports them back home.
Game over. Thank you for playing.
They may be home, but their house is still demolished. Every book off the shelf, every appliance torn to shreds.
I think we're home.
Just kidding, there is a giant black hole. Lisa gets sucked in and dies. The bathtub gets sucked in and dies.
Black hole! Zathura is a black hole!
Zathura has been a black hole this whole time. The very thing they wanted to achieve was their ultimate demise. Their sister, dead. Their house, gone. The Zorgons, dead. Walter, dead. Danny, dead. The game is over and Danny is back home, but his brother and sister are still dead. Just kidding, the boys have made it back home. The gerbil is still alive, the game has been won. After their exciting adventure, the shocking reality sets in that their mom and dad are still divorced and life is still going to be a shit show. Apparently the football never even happened.
What happened to it?
It never happened.
And Lisa might have schizophrenic tendencies from now on.
We never speak of this, okay?
Still think I have gorgeous eyes?
Alright, that was weird. Oh goodness, just a second more, that bicycle would have crushed one of them. Imagine making it through all of that just for the bicycle to crush your little brain. Now that the movie has concluded, I really think it stands the test of time. The budget for this film was $65 million, and in the worldwide box office, they made $65,079,104. This movie really should have been appreciated for. Maybe as an adult, it's a bit corny, but as an adult, it was also enjoyable. Albeit, I have some fond nostalgia for this movie. Zathura is actually pretty long at 101 minutes, almost 2 hours.
That's quite big.
But I can't say it felt too long.
Impressive.
Some scenes may have been drawn out or less interesting, but I feel like the pacing was just fine throughout. Other movies I watched as a kid similar to this one, like Journey to the Center of the Earth, takes like 30 minutes for anything to start happening, but this movie gets kicked off pretty quickly. I think it instills some good messages, but I also think it could do without the weird incestuous jokes throughout.
He obviously feels very protective over me. I just feel so safe around him.
She needs to calm her ass down, bruh. I didn't know you could call someone a dick in the first 4 minutes of a PG-13 film, but I guess that makes sense.
Such a dick!
I think Zathura is a perfect middle-of-the-line movie. It should have gotten more attention, but I also remember that it scared me a lot as a kid. The Zorgons and robots actually instilled the fear of robots in me for a little bit. That thing flew at the wall viciously. You would be mangled.
Hey guys.
It would be like a car with a jet engine hit you. I'd gotta give this movie a 3 out of 5. I think it has a lot of interesting elements and some pretty cool marketing. It's the perfect space adventure for a kid or young teen, and I remembered enjoying it a lot as a kid. Maybe one day I'll pull it up for my nephew or something and see what he thinks, but this movie will still be etched in my mind. Christian Stewart, frozen in ice, the robot trying to kill two young boys, the aliens. When they open the door to space, the giant black hole. This movie was cool as hell, and I've never really seen anyone talk about it. Here's a disclaimer so you remember. I didn't include all the scenes and shots in this movie, so please support the original release. I actually had this movie on DVD from when it came out, so I have purchased this movie. This movie is not owned by me. This is simply commentary meant to critique, analyze, and react within fair use. Please support the original release.